We are the Bob Self Mounting. We're going to take the gondola lift straight up to the top of that mountain.
There. Up
full
there.
View, full view.
Yeah. Now we're gonna go find out how much it is. Let's see if we can afford it.
So take a close up, just in case.
Where to go up.
Yes. For $7 we said we'd come another time. However, we're going to walk up it and it wouldn't cost us a cent. The path is cut in the mountain already, so it's going to be an easy walk. It'll take us about an hour. Let's go. Are you ready?
Yeah,
are you ready?
Ahead.
Let's go.
Yeah, let's go.
We can walk. The only danger in going up is that one of those things might fall on us. Otherwise, no problem. Generations of travelers have walked along the ridge, following an ancient route that connected the prairies to the interior of British Columbia. The landscape before you looked much the same to the native travelers, the white explorers, and the 14 seekers as it does to us today, but its significance has changed with the passing of footsteps.
That's a hoodoo.
Can you see, there's one.
Friendly town, as you can tell. How long have you been here?
Just a matter of hours.
Just a matter of hours? You have to spend at least one night to realize how friendly we people from Banff can be. There's our waiter. See how friendly he is?
Welcome to McDonald's.
Got about 5 minutes, eh? Howdy. Welcome to Lake Louise in the Bar Mountains in Banff. No fish, no fish.
Moose.
Who?
up the mountain up there.
Did you get our tickets for
yes.
the Scott tram?
They're right here.
Thank you very much. We are going to the
Scott tram.
Well, good afternoon. Welcome to the Jasper Tramway. My name is Andy. I'll be your tour guide as we go up the mountain. Just left the lower terminal. It's at an elevation of 4,300 feet. The destination is the upper terminal, we hope. Oh yeah. There's an elevation of 7,500 feet. We'll be traveling at approximately 6 meters per second, so it should take about 7 minutes. The mountain we're traveling, by the way, is Whistler's Mountain, named after the whistling marmot, which is a squirrel-like creature that we often see up here. It's part of the Trident Range. Beginning to leave the tree line of the mountain, and we're entering a part of the mountain called the Alpine Tundra. This area is very similar to the Canadian Arctic. They say for every meter we travel north, or up the mountain, not north, just up the mountain, it's like traveling a kilometer and a half north towards the North Pole. That's how quickly the geography changes. Very little topsoil here. The climate's very harsh. Growing season is only 46 weeks out of the year. In fact, it takes a flower 25 years to bloom up here. We just missed it by 5. If you look up above and to my left here, coming up, we'll go by it, there's a small group of trees. Those are known as crummel, or crippled or crooked wood trees. That's about as tall as they'll grow. They're just up here.
See those many
trees?
It's about as tall as they'll grow, only 4 or 5 feet in height, and Parks Canada estimates those trees to be around 250 years old. It's just an example of how harsh the climate is. There's a beautiful 360-degree view of the area from the summit. Recommend it if you have the time. If you do take the trail though, I'll have to ask you, please don't feed any of the wildlife, because you can't survive very well on chips and peanuts and stuff like that. And don't remove any of the rocks, please, because the rocks hold in whatever little topsoil there is up here for the vegetation to grow. And it's also a $500 fine. Expensive rocks.
How long is the hike to up to the summit?
Well, it's about an hour and a half to go there and back. Like, it's about 45 minutes there.
Walk.
45 minutes. It's a nice walk. It's
it's not too cool, eh? Very nice. It's beautiful.